Hello everyone, this is Michael Cheap with MikesGuitarLessons.com, and I had a special request. Somebody hired me to learn and record for you guys, so I'm going to be playing Sober, teaching you how to play Sober by Pink. And we're going to start off here with the intro to the song. And actually, just so you know exactly what song I'm talking about here, let me play a little bit of it from the actual song here. Okay, now that's the basic chord progression that the intro is built off of, and it gets a little more detailed than that because it changes a little bit into the intro, and I'm going to show you all that right now. So let's go ahead and get started. Now that first part that you just heard is the part that kind of goes like this. You know, you've got your power chords here, and then and that's basically the three chords that the intro is built off of. So they're mainly power chords here, but we're going to get into some other bar chords later. Let's start off with these power chords though. Okay, you're going to start off, just in case you're a beginner and you don't know, we're going to label our strings real quick. This is the skinny E string, this lowest one. This is the B string, or the second string. This is the G string, or the third string. You've got the D string, which is the fourth. The A string is the fifth, and the thick E string, which is the sixth string, okay? Now, you're going to take your first finger and put it on the sixth fret of the A string, playing that note, a little closer so you can see now. And you're going to take your third finger and put it on the eighth fret of the D string, and take your pinky and put it on the eighth fret of the G string, okay? And what you're going to do is just play those three notes in that order, A string, D string, G string. Okay? Okay? Now when you do that, you're going to keep this chord kind of held down, and then I'm going to adjust my angle here so you can see. You're going to slide it down to the second fret, and you want to hear those notes slide down, so you actually want to keep your fingers pressed down. Okay? You hear them slide down. And that second fret with your first finger and fourth fret with your other two fingers, that's the next chord we're going to. So just to know where you're sliding at, you're going to stay on the same strings, but your first finger is going down to the second fret of the A string, and your third finger is going down, it's sliding down to the fourth fret of the D string, and your pinky will be on the fourth fret of the G string. And that's your next chord. You're going to play that chord just like you played the first one. So it's A string, D string, G string. Okay? Alright? After that, we're getting into a chord here that's not actually a bar chord, but it's, I mean, not actually a power chord, but it's still going to be pretty easy as far as this one goes. You're going to take your first finger and put it on the thick E string. Okay, playing that note. Your third finger is going to go on the fourth fret of the D string, playing that note. And this middle finger is going to go on the third fret of the G string. Okay? You're going to play those notes in order. It's going to be the thick E string first, then the D string, then the G string. Okay? Then you're going to go back and play the D string again. Okay, and then you're going to use your pinky to press down in the fourth fret of the G string ahead of this middle finger now, so your note's going to change to the fourth fret. And you're going to play that note really short, like that. So it's going to sound like this. Oh, sorry. Okay? So putting it together, you got your first chord, second chord, and then your third chord. Okay, one more time. Okay, now, the intro is based off of that chord progression the whole time. And I'll say the intro, this is actually the verse too, so we're learning a lot of the song here. It's not a real complicated song. There's a verse, which is also the intro. There's a pre-chorus and there's a chorus. And we just got to get those three parts learned. And we're going to do the verse here, which is also the intro. That's why I was calling it that. So after you've played that, then you're going to kind of start it over. So after you play this, then you start over. Now what you should know are these first two chords, they are the same every single time. So when you start over, you still play this. Okay? But the last part, it changes depending on what time it is that you've gone through this little chord progression. So the first time, you played it like this. Okay? Now the second time, you're going to still play these first two chords the same. But this next chord, you change it a little bit. It's going to sound more like this. Okay? And what that is you're going to hold down the same chord here. First finger on the second fret of the E string, third finger on the fourth fret of the D string, middle finger on the third fret of the G string. You're going to play them in that order, E string, D string, G string. Then you're going to go back to the D string. Then you're going to put that pinky down where you did before on the G string in the fourth fret. And you're going to play it twice. Then go back to the D string and play that note. Now lift that pinky back up. So we're going to play the G string again. It's going to be this middle finger note that we have pressed down now. Okay, so it sounds like this. Okay, now that's the second time that you go through. Okay, so putting those together, it's going to sound like this. Okay, and then the second time. Alright, now the third time we go through the chord progression, we have yet another way of playing it, but we actually don't even use that third chord. We kind of go back to the first one and do something a little different. And I think I can get that in this lesson, so let's go ahead and start it. Play your first two chords the same. Okay? But now you're going to come back up here to that first chord. You're going to play these three notes, A string, D string, G string. And then what I want you to do is kind of reform a chord here. There's a couple ways you could do this, but this is how I'm going to have you do it. Put your middle finger on the seventh fret of the B string, playing that note. Put your first finger on the 6th fret of the G string, playing that note. And what you're going to do is pluck both of those as a chord at the same time. And when you do, you're going to let this third finger hammer and then pull off of the 8th fret of the G string. Okay? Hopefully you already know what hammer-ons and pull-offs are. And then you play 8th fret on the D string, and you slide it down a little bit, and then you start over. So it ends up sounding like this. And you go back up to this chord, and then... Okay, so that was the third time you went through. It's a little easier now. The fourth time you go through, you go back to this, where you go... Okay, and I'm worried that I'm going to run out of time, so the fifth time through is a little bit different, but you can catch that on my website. It's www.mikesguitarlessons.com, and I'll have all the videos for this video, the pre-course video, and the course video. Anything that's in the song, I'll have up there on the website. Not to mention tons of other very new songs or classic rock songs, scales, chords, charts, anything that you want to know how to play. I most likely have a lesson for something similar or that exact thing on the website. So I hope you enjoy the lesson. Please check out the website and